so many forms. This agrees with the purpose God had since the beginning of time, and he carried out his plan through Christ Jesus our Lord. In Christ, we can come before God with freedom and without fear. We can do this through faith in Christ. So I ask you not to become discouraged because of the suffering I am having for you. My suffering are for your glory, the love of Christ. So I bow in prayer before the Father, from whom every family in heaven on earth gets its true name. I ask the Father in his great glory to give you the power to be strong inwardly through his Spirit. I pray that Christ will live in your hearts by faith, and that your life will be strong in love and be built on love. And I pray that you and all God's holy people will have the power to understand the greatness of Christ's love, how wide, how long, and how high, how deep that love is. Christ's love is greater than anyone can ever know. But I pray that you will be able to know that love. Then you can be filled with the fullness of God. With God's power working in us, God can do much, much more than anything we can ask or imagine. To him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus for all time, forever and ever. Amen. Life lessons. Ephesians 3, 1-21. Situation. Paul told the Ephesians his goals for them. He shared his prayer for their growth in insight and strength. Observation. Although God's love for us cannot be measured by any comprehensible standard, God wants us to know this ocean of love. Inspiration. The promises of God's love and forgiveness are real, as sure, as positive as human words can make them. But like describing the ocean, its total beauty cannot be understood until it's actually seen. It is the same with God's love. Until you actually accept it, until you actually experience it, until you actually possess true peace with God, no one can describe its wonders to you. It is not something that you can do with your mind. Your finite mind is not capable of dealing with anything as great as the love of God. Your mind might have difficulty explaining how a black cow can eat green grass and give white milk. But you drink the milk and are nourished by it. Your mind can't reason through all that intricate process that takes place. When you plant a small flat seed that produces a huge, fine, bearing luscious red and green watermelons, but you eat them and enjoy them. You can't understand radio, but you listen. Your mind can't explain the electricity that may be creating the light by which you are reading at this very moment, but you know that it's there and that it's making possible for you to read. From Peace and with God by Billy Graham. Application. Learn to see God's love for you in the details of daily life. Read 1 John and get a firmer grasp on understanding God's love. It is hard to explain or to put into words what that love is. How love can be an ocean. It's like explaining the whole radio and even me making these videos. We don't know how a little camera can provide footage into space for you guys to see it in another country, in another world. Say hello. I'd love to hear from you guys. And we will see you next time.